Welcome back, gang. So now what we want to do is start setting up some factories to add some information into the database, the user information to the database, so that we can start actually playing around with some of these users and create a members page and all that good stuff. So let's start with our factories. We want to go to database factories, and we already have two here. This one came with the installation, and this one we created very early on. I think it was maybe the first or second episode. Okay, so now we want to go here down to the user factory, and we'll go down to the return section. Now we added another field into this the table, so we want to make sure that we go ahead and add that new field here, which will be user name. Okay, and then we'll do this Baker user name. Now Laravel comes with Faker, which is actually pretty cool for doing this stuff, so it already has a field set for it. And as you can see in the default installation, it already has name, email, and that's already set up for us, so we're good there. The next one we need to do is now our profile factory. So our profile factory has a couple of things that we haven't touched yet, which will be the, let's see how we can do this. First, let's bring this up. Okay, and then in the definition, what we're going to want to do is set up some variables first, because it'll make it a lot cleaner in the actual return. So gender equals, and then we're going to put an array, and our genders that we have set up, or that this is just dummy information, so it doesn't really matter. You can put whatever you want to put here. So male, female, semicolon, and then the next variable we're going to create is the slug. And that's going to be this Faker. And then we'll just use name for that. It really doesn't matter. You can put whatever you want there. So now for the return, now we can create slug equals. We're going to use the string helper. And then this will be slug, and this is the slug variable up here. Okay, and then the actual slug is gonna have a separator, and that's what that is, comma. The next field will be gender equals, and then what we're gonna do is have it give us a random array of this gender field, the variable that we made up here. So it'll randomly add male or female to whichever user is getting created. Okay, and then we'll add the variable in here. We'll just add a comma. Let's just make sure these are imported up top. Okay, so it's going to be illuminate support. And then array was already found. So let's scroll up, and they're both support. Okay. So now, in order to get this to work, we need to go to the Cedar database Cedar file, and we can go ahead and uncomment this one. Okay. Bring that up. And now we're going to create, we can leave it at 10. It's fine. What we also want to do is, Laravel has this cool way of, if you have relationships within the models already set up, then you can add those, you can attach those relationships to your Cedar. I need to add an arrow here. So has profile is what the relationship is. So this user, these users each have profiles create. So we're just going to create 10. Now let's go ahead and see if this works, or if everything blows up. We'll find out in a second. So now to run the Cedar, it will be PHP artisan db seed. and enter. Database seeding. Okay, now let's check our database. So we'll go here and open up our database. Okay, so it's social network, that's the one that we want. Okay, so now we should have 10, well, we should have 11 users because we already had one that we created before. And here you go. So now this is the user that we initially created. And these are the new users we just seeded. Okay, and they all have everything in there. Okay, now if you also go to the profiles tab, you can see that they also have profiles with usernames. With slugs and with gender. Okay, so yeah, I think that's it. Okay, we'll get started with creating a page for the members in the next episode. Maybe, yeah, we'll start working on it in the next episode. Okay, thanks for watching, guys. I'm gonna go ahead and push this up to GitHub. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.